Welcome back. I hope you guys are happy, healthy, ready to do some math. But I think I'm going to start this just like I start class every day with some welcomes and some hellos. So usually I would say, good morning, Libby Lou. Morning, sunshine. Lucy, why are you late? Wishy-washy, take your earplugs out. Nate the Great, how you been? Miles, your shoes untied. Kellen, put your phone away. And last but not least, from. So every time I make a video, I'll try to say hi as much as I can. I know usually in class, I try to say it to everybody every day. If I greeted everybody every video, I think you guys might get a little sick of it. So just I'll make sure I hit everybody. So hi to all of you who I did not mention, and I'll be mentioning you later. So the first thing I'd like to do is update you on the current state of the AP tests. So they're still on, 100% for sure. College Board has sent that out. They will be testing as usual. You'll still be able to earn college credit. There's going to be significant changes, though, in the format of the test, and I will share some of that with you. The rest of it we'll be sharing as more information comes out on April 3rd. But I'll share with you what's public knowledge, like what you could find if you looked at tweets from College Board or got on their website. So, again, the test will be offered. The date and dates are unknown. That will be coming out on Friday. Next up, the test is going to be shortened to 45 minutes. So from 3.5 hours to 45 minutes, it will be done via computer and remotely. So that's going to be really interesting how we squeeze a 3.5 hour test into 45 minutes. Also, they've said they're not going to have any multiple choice on it. So again, I don't know, don't ask me any questions as to how that's going to look. We don't know that yet. What else did I miss here? It's for BC, and colleges will still be accepting credit, so that's good. You'll still be scored, I believe, on a scale of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So it's going to be kind of business as usual for College Board with the testing, except the format of the test is going to be really different. I have a piece of hair sticking up. Oh, that made it worse. Ah, there we go. All right. The other thing is they're, I feel like I'm missing something. Oh, they're cutting out some content because a lot of the class, schools and classes aren't going to have as much time. Obviously, we just lost a full 2 weeks here. Also in Minnesota, we start sometimes close to a month later than other schools do across the nation and across the world. So yeah, we're sort of significantly behind. To help with that, College Board has cut out some content that's going to be testing. But for AB, unfortunately, what they chose to cut is something that we not only did, we did for a long time. They're cutting out all the area and volume. So no discs, no washers, no cross sections. That's all been cut out. So we still need to finish what we haven't finished yet. Unfortunately, that's not the stuff that got cut. So just unluck in sequencing, I guess. So we're going to continue, and I want to tell you what the days are going to look like and where the most important documents for you are. So the first thing I'm going to show you here is, I think I'll go to a share screen. So you can see my desktop here. So in Schoology, there's a couple things that I want you to really be watching. I'm going to be hiding most of this, and some of it's already hidden. But once we get started, I'm going to get rid of that Unit 6. I just have some people making up some missed work in there. Same with Unit 5. I'll be getting rid of that. So you should really only see two things when you get in. The optional test review links, I'll have that open March through May. Those are extra credit opportunities. Remember, I do not round grades. So if you end up with a 79.6, you're getting a C+. I'm not doing the rounding stuff because I offer points all the time along the way to bump you over those fine lines between grades. And if you're not choosing to do that, then I don't think you've earned the bump. So this will be open the whole time. This is our main workflow folder. So starting 3:30. In before we start, this is the thing that I would keep open. I'd have it open tab all the time. It's going to be a daily workflow schedule. So between this folder and this Google Doc, you should have a really good idea what you're supposed to be doing every day. So on this document, I list what you're doing that day. What do you need to do? Watch this video. If you have not, like this is for Monday, if you never finished that Delta math that was assigned on Thursday 3/12, it was technically assigned on 3/12. Some of you finished it in class that day. Others chose not to work on it, which was fine because I said it wasn't due until the 16th. Well, then I was gone on the 13th, and then we had this whole issue. But it's been out there, it's been open, and it needs to be wrapped up by 2 o'clock on Monday. So I suggest doing that as soon as possible. I am not going to extend that time since it'll have been close to 3 weeks by the time you do that. So every single day, it'll say exactly what you need to do. So Wednesday, it says notes video for exponential growth, take notes, and then take a Schoology quiz. So no homework that day, just notes and a Schoology quiz on the notes. If there's sometimes there'll be things that you absolutely have to do at a specific time to get points. If you miss those times, again, do some extra credit to make up those points. But for example, on Friday, we'll be playing quizzes virtually. Well, I'm only going to have that open at 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock, and 3 o'clock for periods 1, 2, 6, respectively. So make sure you're reading this and following this. You're like, okay, I got to get on quizzes at 1 o'clock today. If for some reason you can't, shoot me an email, but really try to get those things done at exactly the time it says. Next, when there's a test, how are we going to test in here? We're going to be working in that AP classroom most of the time. We'll be going in through the secure mode, which we did. If you forgot how to do that, maybe I'll upload a document to remind you. But I think most of you, unless you were absent on Friday, did that and did that successfully. So we'll be testing in there. But the key to that is, they're all going to be timed. It's my only way to try to at least control a little bit how much you're using your phones and using each other. I shuffle the questions so your number ones aren't the same as other people's number ones. I also put a reasonable time limit on there. So if you're Googling, if you're trying to find other stuff on other computers, if you're snapping, that's just going to eat up your time and you're probably not going to get as far as the rest, and your short score will show that. So what if the question comes up, well, what if I missed that 3 o'clock deadline? Maybe I fell asleep and I had a nap. Well, obviously I have to give you the opportunity to take a test, but I will tell you it won't be the same test. And what that means is when I go into AP Classroom and select questions, I select ones that I think best fit what we're doing. So they're the ones we prep for. So this video right here, prep video for the test, some of these questions are exactly the ones on the test. Others are really similar. For the late take one, if I need to make one, they will not be similar, and they're probably going to be more difficult. And that's the only way I can do it in that form. So you're just going to really have to try your best to get to those test times on time. Set an alarm, do something. All right, so this is your main workflow. I would definitely keep that tab open at the top of your screen and just every day look at it and say, what do I need to do today? And then once you decide, okay, I need to go take notes and take a Schoology quiz, that's when you're going to go back to your workflow. And on those given days, and you don't have access to these yet, I'm not going to give you access to the workflow until Monday. But on Monday when it said take notes, there they are right here. This is the PDF. If you have a printer at home, print it off. Otherwise, I tell you to do it in a notebook. And then it says right here, take the quiz on those. Now, you get to use the notes on the quiz. The quiz is really easy if you've taken the notes. And it's timed, so make sure you don't have those videos running while you're taking the notes. I think I have it timed at like 1 minute, because if you took the notes, all the answers are in there. So again, just make sure you're I guess I feel like I'm rambling on, but I'm trying to get a lot of information. What I really want to advise you guys, so let's keep it real here for a second. Life Lessons by LaRude, episode 28 of the year. I talk a lot in class about how changing our mindset from education as task completion. And you guys know I've said it a lot. I said, don't just do this to complete the task, because there's so many ways you can get tasks done. You can copy other people. You can copy my keys. You can Google. You can photo math. You can, there's so many ways of completing tasks to get those little homework points in the grade book. If that's your intent, the test scores always suffer with that. And we're trying to earn college credit here, so you really want to learn it. You're going to need it. I'm hoping that you chose calculus as your as one of your electives, because you know you're going to need it for what you eventually want to do or be someday. So we really are trying, or I'm really trying with you guys, to change that task completion mindset to I'm doing it because I need to learn it. And I know there's going to be ways around this, like as far as, I guess, not being authentic while testing and or while doing the homework. And honestly, I can't fix that. I'll do the best I can, but I'm just going to leave you on your honor. And I really hope that those of you who haven't changed that mindset from task completion to learning the content will kind of take this as an opportunity to do so. You could ask almost anybody in my department or anyone who's asked me, when they ask me about this year's AB students, what do I say? And I do say they are the most authentic bunch I think I've ever had. There's so little of that. There's so little key copying. There's so little just doing stuff to get something done and giving me crap for homework. It's actually on the opposite side. It's so well done. You guys are, you work so hard. And the life lessons aren't for all, they're for some. But as a group, you guys have just been spectacular this year with how you approach your coursework. So, and it's really starting to show on the test. And I'm going to be brutally honest, at the beginning of this year, our first two tests were among the lowest I've ever had as far as test averages. But as you're becoming quality learners, I've noticed this last test, it was the highest by far. And that was a hard test, that chapter 5 test. So I just, kudos to you guys. You're doing awesome. I just hope we can keep that up through this e-learning, because we really want to earn those college credits, right? So to wrap this up, we've got two main things that you really need to be working with every day. You need to be checking the master schedule every morning. Okay, what do I need to do today? What do I need to turn in today? And then all the stuff you need is going to be in each day or day's folder. And so you should be able to work through that pretty seamlessly. Lastly, and this is only for those of you who, if you saw your last test score in Schoology, it was for the one that you took in the Zabe Theater on Friday the 13th. And if you would like the opportunity to earn some more tests, points back on that. I'm not going to give a retake, but I'm going to let you interact with the most missed mistakes and then do just 3 questions in Delta Math to verify that you've indeed learned the content. You can earn up to 5 test points back on that. That's quite a bit. And you can do that whether you got a 14 out of 15 or a 13 out of 15 or a 7 out of 15, but there'll be a max of 5. So if you want to, I have that open already. So that you could do anytime you want. I would just need it by Monday night. So if you still want to wait till Monday, that's fine, but it's not new content. So if that's something you want to start ahead of time, feel free to do it. So it says, do you want to earn some test points? And if you click on that in Schoology, it'll say exactly what you need to do. All right. So I guess that's it for my welcome back, kind of a long video, but I had a lot to tell you guys. Oh, no, it's going to load. So let's stop sharing, and I'm going to say I know you guys are going to be successful. I just have a ton of confidence in you. Have confidence in yourself. Reach out to me at any time, and this isn't easy on anybody, but if any group of people could handle it, you guys get my vote, that's for sure. So I miss you. I look forward to interacting with you, if only digitally. One nice thing is, I can go to work wearing a Twins t-shirt with camouflage pants that don't even match. And you guys will never know unless I point it out. Anyway, you guys are great, and I will be seeing you on Monday.